Hello folks, this is Ayatin Ajha from InspireToRise.com and today we are going to unbox and review the HP Pavilion 14BF125TX. So this device comes in this packaging. Inside you get the setup instructions, the power cable and the HP laptop itself. Nothing too much fancy in here, and the build and design feels solid for this laptop. On the right hand side you get the LAN port, HDMI port, USB type C port and the charging port. It comes with Bang & Olufsen speakers and the audio is definitely rich. The trackpad is good but nowhere close to as seen on Apple laptops or some other high-end laptops. And if I talk about few of the things like the build quality and design, it's good, plasticky, not aluminium unibody style design but still does get the job done and feels sturdy to use. It comes with a 3-cell 41 watt hour lithium ion battery and a 90 watt AC power adapter. They claim the battery life of up to 10 hours and 30 minutes, but I was getting around 7 to 8 hours of usage on balanced power profile and very less on the high performance power profile. On the left hand side there are two USB 3.1 generation 1 ports, a 3.5mm jack, a Kensington lock port and an SD card reader. It comes preloaded with Windows 10 Home 64-bit edition, and there's something about the hinge which you should see. So every time you open up this laptop, the hinge makes sure that the device is arched in a certain way which makes it a little bit more comfortable to type on, and I like this welcome addition. It comes with a 14-inch diagonal display which is sort of made to fit in a 13-inch form factor, and I like the fact that they have not wasted any space on the display. So plus one for this. It comes with a 1080p panel and the quality is not really that great to write home about, but still it's doable and gets your job done. And if I talk about the typing experience on this one, the click clack sound is present on this keyboard and it definitely feels good to type upon. It's a full-size island-style LED backlit keyboard, but sadly you can't control the intensity of the keyboard LED lights, so that's another con. If you talk about what's on the inside, it comes with latest Coffee Lake Intel CPUs. It has the Intel Core i5-8250U on the inside, maximum clock speed of around 3400 MHz, and if you talk about the L3 cache, it's around 6 MB. The base clock is just set to 1.6 GHz, so that's very limiting, and I had to install Bitsum Process Lasso in order to get the most out of this laptop, and it comes with a lot of preloaded bloatware which I had to remove. Just has 8 GB of RAM, but you can add another 8 GB stick later on. Comes with Intel UHD Graphics 620 and also Nvidia GeForce 940MX dedicated graphics with 2 GB of memory. If you talk about the processor performance, it holds its own against a lot of previous desktop offerings. These are most notably because of the architectural changes and few other clock speed improvements, along with the fact that it comes with 4 cores and 8 threads now. You can take a closer look at the benchmark scores for this laptop on the Geekbench benchmark, as well as for the storage benchmark. It has a 1TB 5400 RPM hard drive, which is nowhere close to SSD read-write speeds, and the benchmark scores were terrible for that. If I talk about performance during gameplay, the lack of an SSD was one of the most limiting factors for this laptop, and it can definitely benefit from a faster storage. Now let's talk about gaming on this device. I tried playing some modern games like Grand Theft Auto 5 and the best I could get was 60 FPS with everything set to normal and the post-processing set to ultra, so the graphics looked really great on 720p. I was able to get easily 60 FPS constant and I was able to play something like Grand Theft Auto 5. If we talk about Counter-Strike Global Offensive, I was able to play this game on 1080p with everything set to low and easily getting 60 FPS or 60 plus FPS on this. But I have to tell you something, that there is a lot of bloatware present on this laptop and the lack of an SSD makes games sometimes lag, and there is this occasional stutter which makes games look a little bit bad. If I talk about something like PUBG PlayerUnknown Battlegrounds, it's a heavy game and I was able to get only around 47 to 58 FPS when playing on really low settings on 720p. So definitely not meant for long-term gaming. The real issue here is that this laptop gets too warm while playing, so you can expect temperatures up to 42 degrees Celsius or even more depending upon how long you are playing, but the keyboard does not become that much warm, so that's a saving grace. And now let's test the audio output. audio was crisp and clear with sufficient bass, but the maximum volume was not that high. So if you are going to use it for too much of your multimedia needs, you would be disappointed. The HP Pavilion 14BF125TX retails for a price of 64,861 on the HP shopping website. And if I talk about all of the pros and cons of this device, it has a lot of pros, but if you talk about the cons, it comes preloaded with McAfee software, comes preloaded with a lot of HP bloatware which you have to remove in order to get a stable experience. And if you talk about the graphics card performance, it's not that great, does not come with an SSD at this price point, and you can get something like a MacBook Air or even few other Windows laptops which might be more powerful than this one. Still, if you're somebody who is in the HP camp and loves using products like this one, if you're somebody who wants a good laptop whose battery life would last long, and if you're somebody who is looking for all of these features which this laptop already has, then you might be pleased with this one. So guys, this was it for this video. In case you like this one, don't forget to smash the thumbs up button. Do subscribe to Inspire to Rise, it makes my day better. And guys, no matter what you do, stay inspired to rise. You know,